Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Jewel, aka Mr. Pristine, and welcome to my channel, Pristine Tech. Today I'm going to be doing another video on a device that I personally like, no matter what anybody has to say about it. Not to say that lots of people have said negatives about it, but there are some people out there that have kind of slammed this phone a little bit. But again, it's just a matter of preference. So without further ado, let's get into it. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the LG Stylo 2 Plus. This is a phone that was originally released, I believe, back in late 2015. And so this is the Plus edition of the phone, which was just released on the 1st of August, if I'm not mistaken. It's a phablet phone. It's a 5.7 inch screen. The phone is very light. You can see in my hand, it's a big phone, but it's not heavy. It's not heavy at all. I mean, it's a featherweight compared to a lot of phones that are out there with this particular size. Pretty interesting device. So some of the specs, again, as I mentioned, it's a 5.7 inch 1280 by 720 pixel display. Now, according to a lot of the reviews that I read, some people slammed it on that because they would have preferred a 1080p screen or a quad HD screen. You know, those things are nice and all. They're nice additions to a phone, but are they really all that necessary? I mean, really the only thing that could be affecting is battery life, and so oftentimes, for the sake of battery life, I would prefer a 720 screen. The screen is crystal clear. It looks phenomenal. I mean, and you can barely tell a difference between a 720 and a 1080p screen, my personal opinion. So double tap to turn the screen on. And we do have a fingerprint scanner on board. Which is a wonderful thing, but yeah, my camera's not focusing on it, but you can see the screen is nice and bright. I mean, it's at halfway right now. The apps are nice and crisp. The colors, they just pop out at you. Seamless ability to sway from side to side to access apps. Again, this is an LG product, and you know, LG, they've got that 3D feature where you can do like a carousel effect. That is dope. I'll never get tired of doing that. I personally like the display. I think the display looks really good. But again, you know, you're going to have, you know, people out there that are going to want the quad HDs and the 1080p screens, and that's fine. I mean, again, it's just a matter of preference. Absolutely nothing wrong with this screen quality that this phone possesses. Let's see. It's shipped with 6.0.1 Marshmallow, which is good. We've got a 1.4 gigahertz octa-core Qualcomm Snapdragon processor on board. We've got 2 gigs of RAM, 16 gigs of ROM, and we've got SD card support up to 2 terabytes. So it's good that this has the expandable memory, especially that it's only coming with 16 gigs, which oftentimes, a lot of times, because of the apps that are already pre-installed on the phone, you're not really getting 16 gigs right out of the box. You're getting maybe 12 or 10, you know, or something like that. So it's always a good thing, you know, for people out there that are heavy downloaders or they store files. Stuff like that, you know, it's good to have the ability to be able to expand the memory to, you know, whatever you want to expand it to, you know, whatever you feel your needs are. So shout out to LG for putting that in this particular phone. As far as design, we've got a 6.1 by 3.13 by 0.29 inch device, and this phone is 5.07 ounces. It's very, very, very light. I mean, it feels really good in the hand. You can see the back has a slight curve to it, which definitely helps grip the phone. It is kind of a wide phone, but it feels good in the hand. Let's see, the back, it's got, this is a removable back, and the battery is removable, so that is a plus for people that are just power users, and you don't have to worry about keeping a charger with you. You can just get yourself another battery or two, keep it with you, and whenever this particular one dies, you can swap it out, and you're back in business. And so LG, I mean, they're good with the accessories. They tend to make a lot of accessories for their phones, especially phones that you can remove the battery. You can get additional batteries for very good prices. They have like these little mini carry with you battery chargers. So if this one dies and you need to pop another one in it, you can just charge it on the go. So that when the new one dies, then you can put the one that was in it originally back in it. And so you'll never run out of battery life. And so that's a good look with LG. This is like a gold matte finish. It's like a gold or a dark brown. The phone is a beautiful phone. It's got very thin bezels on the side. Of course, we've got the LG branding right there on the bottom. Up top here is where we've got our 5-megapixel selfie cam. The ear speaker right there, it's like gold. And there's also like a gold trim around the phone. It looks really slick. This is a very slick looking phone. It's a very attractive looking phone. And me personally, I'm very much so into cosmetics. And so I like the way that this phone looks. But you can see this is the left side of the phone. And I thought that this was the side where our nano SIM tray was, but I guess I was mistaken. Actually, that's in the back when you take the back off. So my apologies. Bottom of the phone, we've got the 3.5-millimeter headphone jack, and we've got a micro USB for charging, no Type-C. And actually, you know, we don't have any buttons on the sides because this is a rear key device. And I'm actually a big fan of this. I know that some people, they slam this idea. Me personally, I don't mind it because when you hold the phone, your fingers are right there anyway, touching it. And so we've got the volume rocker here, up or down, up. In the middle there, we've got our power key, and that also functions as the fingerprint scanner as well, which is a very responsive fingerprint scanner. We've got a 13-megapixel camera here, and we've got the LED flash right here. And camera quality is really good, by the way, but we'll talk about that a little later on in the video. The buttons, they feel nice and tactile. They don't protrude much, but they feel really good. They've got some texture to them, so you definitely know if your finger is on a button. It definitely feels different from the plastic back here on the phone. We've got the LG branding there, and once again, this is one of the flaws that I have with these phones. We've got the speaker on the back. Again, I can't understand why these phone companies and manufacturers continue to do this. I don't know if it's to cut cost, but my personal opinion, a battery on the back, or excuse me, a speaker on the back of the phone is never a good look. Either place it on the bottom if you can't place it on the front. Because again, when you set the phone down on flat surfaces, typically we all set our phones down on their backs. And so if you're trying to listen to music through the speaker, if you're not connected to headphones, whether wired or Bluetooth, or you're watching a movie on Netflix or watching a show on Hulu or something, or you're watching some footage on YouTube, you're gonna have a very hard time hearing if the phone is flat on the surface. Now, if you pick it up and hold it in your hand and kind of cuff your hand around the speaker like so, then that makes a bit of a difference, but you may not want to hold the phone. I mean, so if that's the case, you can invest in a case where it has the little kickstands where you can prop the phone up, and that will help the sound a bit. But yeah, me personally, I'm not really a big fan of the speakers on the back. That's just my personal opinion, or my feeling towards speakers being on the back. But aside from that, I mean, very solid performance so far from this particular device. Now, another one of the main things that I love about this device is it's very comparable to the Samsung Note series. Why? Because it has a stylus, and the stylus is embedded. If you can see, ladies and gentlemen, that little notch right there, and just peel it out with a fingernail, and it comes out. And you'll notice that when you take it out, just like you could on a Note 5, you can scribble on the screen and make notes, draw pictures or doodle, you know, whatever you want to do. To me, this is an amazing feature. I'm a big fan of this just because I'm a neat freak, and I've got OCD really bad, and I can't stand a lot of clutter, and I don't like a lot of paper clutter. But the profession that I'm in, and just random stuff, just information that comes by that I like to remember, sometimes you got to write it down. Well, this gives me the ability to just pull the pen out. I can jot it down. I could save it in my memos or save it into my picture gallery, and I've got it. And so the functionality of this pen is also very Note-ish, if that's a word, Samsung Note-ish, because apparently the previous Stylo or Stylo phone, the pen didn't have functionality. It was just more, just the stylus to kind of navigate from screen to screen and maybe touch on an app or something like that to open up the app. And you could do like some little drawing and stuff like that. But this has been upgraded to have more feature functions. And so I know the phone possesses split screen. You can do stuff with the pen there, drawing, doodling. You can really get creative with this little pen. And so this is a very, very nice touch. I really like having the ability to have this pen, which is also one of the main reasons why I like the Samsung Note series. But the good thing about this is only going to run you like $230 as opposed to, say, the Note 7 that comes out tomorrow. That phone is $850, depending on where you get it. I mean, I know I've got mine on order. I'm going to pick it up in the morning. But I'm with T-Mobile, and it costs $850 at T-Mobile. It may be more at other carriers. So if you're looking for a device that has a stylus capability, then you may want to take a good look at the Stylo 2 Plus. Now, let's go ahead and slide the stylus pen back in there. You heard the little noise that it makes. And I also believe that if the pen gets too far away from the device will beep, sending an indication that the pen has been removed and that it is, you know, too far away from the device. So that's a nice look as well, just to kind of give you a heads up or a reminder to, you know, keep it together. So that's a nice touch. I know that the notes, they do that as well. So let's see. There's no app drawer on this phone. And this is also something that I read where people were kind of upset about that. And we're starting to, different phones, you know, they have different functionalities and features and they do different things. They all pretty much do the same things, but they just do them differently, as I've mentioned in other videos. This particular phone here happens to not have an app drawer. And I understand that the majority of Android phones have app drawers, and so I get it. You know, it's something that you're used to having, and then all of a sudden you get a device and you don't have it. There are, through the Play Store, applications that you can download to where you can completely, like, change the theme. And LG, they also have a theme store where you can go in and you can pick different themes. And I do believe that certain themes that you choose, they come with an app drawer. So if you want to get an app drawer, you may just want to think about possibly just changing your theme, or just downloading something from the Google Play Store that has an app drawer. I mean, it's that simple. I mean, if you're not really a big fan of the no app drawer, then that will be a quick fix. But I mean, as far as the no app drawer, it's no different from an iPhone. You know, iPhones, they've never had an app drawer. I understand it's a different operating system. But the way it works is, let's see, like this particular screen, for instance, which is my home screen. There's room down here to put more apps. So once this page gets filled up with apps and I want to download more apps, then it would just create another page. So you're never going to run out of space for your apps. I mean, it just, There's no app drawer for you to push to access all your apps in one area. All your apps are going to be on these little home screens that you can just navigate back and forth to from left to right. And that's how it works. I mean, me, it's not really a problem. I mean, as long as I can access my apps, I don't really have an issue. It's not really a big deal whether there's an app drawer or not. As long as I can get to the app and access it and do what it is that I'm looking to do, then no app drawer for me is no problem. But it might be an issue for you. I mean, so if it's something that you just can't stand, then and you're not willing to, you know, change the theme up or download a different interface from the Play Store, then this may not be it may not be an option for you. But me personally, I think it's an all around. It's a solid device. I've had it for about a week now. I've been using it as my daily driver since I got it about a week ago. Me personally, I don't really have any complaints with it. This is actually my first LG Stylo phone, but I saw it in T-Mobile and I hadn't seen it before. I've seen the original Stylo, and I saw that this was the Plus and that it just recently came out, and so I felt compelled to get my hands on it and test it out. Of course, did the homework to see what the improvements were from the previous Stylo 2 that was released in late 2015. There were some pretty good upgrades to this particular device, and so I'm enjoying myself with it. Now let's talk a little bit about the camera. Again, it's got a 13 megapixel rear facing camera with LED flash, and it's got the 5 megapixel front facing camera, which it's a very, very solid camera experience, both front and back. Now, you're not going to get LG G5 picture quality, but the pictures, it takes really good photos. And LG, I mean, that seems to be something that they kind of pride themselves in with their devices. I mean, I've never had an LG phone where the camera was just completely terrible. It may have not have been the top of the line, but it definitely wasn't the worst out there. And so, you know, when you've got devices like the LG G5 or the S7 or the S7 Edge, where they've just got phenomenal cameras front and back, I mean, you're not going to quite get that same experience on the Stylo 2, but it's pretty close to it. I mean, the pictures, the color saturation is right on point. I mean, they pop out at you. The screen is crystal clear. The pictures are crystal clear. And again, like I said, I don't typically like to get into a lot of the politics with the pictures. Again, just to me, what looks good with the naked eye, if the pictures look natural and I can see everything clearly, things don't look fuzzy or washed out, then to me that's a good camera experience, and I was able to get that in both the rear-facing and the front-facing camera on this particular device. And so for me, I'd say the camera is a go. If you're somebody where camera functionality is important to you, this is a very solid functioning camera on this device. I think another good thing about this phone again is the price. This is the T-Mobile version of this device, where it is $230. I know that some places, I know Metro PCS, they sell this for $149.99, and I believe that you can buy it from Walmart unlocked for $199. So that's still a great value. This phone is unlock capable. And it's GSM, so it works. Once it's unlocked, it works with T-Mobile, AT&T, Metro PCS, Cricket Wireless, any other GSM carriers that you can think of. This phone should work. It should do just fine. Again, removable back. Let's go ahead and pop the back off for you. So you see there is the SIM card tray right there. It is a nano SIM. Here's the battery right here, which is removable. And I believe the SD card slot is underneath the nano SIM tray. So they're kind of stacked on top of one another. I know you can see the SIM right there. So I believe that the SD card slot is right underneath that. And so in order to slip in your SD card, you would have to take the battery out, slip it in, and then put the battery back in, put the bag back on, turn the phone on, and there you go. So it's just as simple as that. And so I know a lot of people, I mean, will find this feature attractive. I've seen a lot of devices get completely slammed because they didn't have a removable back, and maybe it was something that previous models had once before, and it turned out to be disappointing for a lot of customers that still would have liked to have that feature. So shout out to LG for allowing people the access to the back and removing the battery and so forth. It's a good little feature to have. So again, what else can I tell you? Just my final thoughts and personal opinions about this phone. I think this phone is a really good device. I know that it's going to be compared heavily to the Note series, primarily the Note 5 and the Note 7, especially with the Note 7 coming out tomorrow. I don't believe there are any other phones that come with the stylus, which is why I can see why these two would be heavily compared. But again, I mean, this is considered a budget device because of the price. But as far as the specs, it performs very, very well. Again, it's very snappy. Again, as we can see, there's no lag. Let's see. Let me go ahead and open up my Bible app because I know some of y'all need Jesus. Go ahead and open up the app. And there it is. I mean, you know, to me, I mean, it works. I mean, it may not be the fastest, but it's definitely not the slowest. It's just a matter of seconds. I mean, it's not the OnePlus 3 or anything where as soon as you touch the app, then boom, you know, there's the material. But it works. It works really well. Yeah, there it is again. So, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, this is the LG Stylo 2 Plus. I would recommend this phone to anybody. Again, it's a very, very overall solid device. With the exception of the speaker being on the back, the sound quality is decent. You know, it's not the best, but it's doable. But, you know, we live in a day and age now where most people are using headphones, whether wired or Bluetooth. I know me personally, I never talk with my phone to my ear. I've always got my Bluetooth device in my headset. But the call quality also on this phone is absolutely phenomenal. The voices are rich. They're extremely clear. I kind of get the feel as though I'm on a landline. That's how it sounds. And the person on the other end of the phone, they say that they can hear me really clearly as well. So no problem with the call quality on this phone. So again, this is just, it's a solid device. I would recommend it to anybody. And definitely, you know, if you are fans of the Note, but you don't want to drop, you know, $850, or, you know, you may be strapped and you can't really afford the lease plans that a lot of the phone carriers do, and you want an option that has a stylus pen, this is definitely the one, the option to go with. This is the LG Stylo 2 Plus. If you like this video, if you found it useful and informative, please like, hit that thumbs up. Please share the video and hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. I'm going to be producing a lot of material. I'm going to be updating a lot of the top phones that are going to be coming out and that are out currently. I've already got 6 videos that are posted. If you haven't checked those out, I believe those are down below. You guys can go ahead and check those out as well. Again, I appreciate the love and the support. I've been doing this for about a month, so it hasn't been that long, but I've gotten a lot of great feedback. And so I really appreciate the support, the subscribers, the likes, and people sharing the video. It's really appreciative. It definitely helps the channel. And I just ask that, you know, this thing continue to move. I'll continue to pump out these videos for you and do my absolute best to provide you with the information that you need to help you make an informed decision on a smartphone that you may want to spend your money on. Until the next video, please, you guys stay blessed, stay safe, and definitely stay pristine. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.